It's sunny in London, not so much in Venezuela. After months of blackouts, absolute blackouts in the country, we're here today to ask yet another very important question. The question that brings us together today is, who is pulling the strings in Venezuela? People talk about the interference of Russian militaries, Cuban strategy and intelligence, as well as China, even helping Venezuela producing cryptocurrency. So we're going to ask people today, what do you think is really behind the Venezuelan crisis? Hi, good morning. Do you know about the crisis in Venezuela?
Sort of.
Have you heard about it? What have you heard?
Is it Maduro? Maduro, yeah. There was a kind of a coup, and there's a lot of accusations from him about the US government being involved. And
hi, good morning. Have you heard about the crisis in Venezuela?
No, I haven't.
It's a country in South America that has been facing a dictatorship for the last 20 years. The dictatorship is so-called Bolivarian socialism, and essentially the idea is that you control all the powers, like institutions, imagine the parliament, all collided just around one single figure. Venezuelans have been suffering, they have nothing to eat, no electricity and no water supplies, and we're deeply worried about it.
That sounds really terrible. I had no idea that was going on in the world.
I think the situation is terrible in the country, and the situation is caused by the American economic sanctions many years ago. They're strangling the country, strangling the population, and it's an absolute disgrace. They've done it in Iraq, they've done it in Afghanistan, they want to do it in Iran, and they're doing it right now in Venezuela. It's a disgrace, the American economic policy.
And what do you think about Russia and China in all this big mess? Because they have huge, huge contacts with Venezuela. Do you think that the Russian and the Chinese have something more than mere economic interests?
I really don't know. My opinion, my past experience is that America is a big imperialist country which just wants to take over the world. Any country which has got petrol, they want to move in and control it for their own personal financial gain.
What is her view or your view of the fact that also Russia, China and Cuba have had a big influence in all the mess that has been happening in Venezuela?
Yeah, but I think this is the same around the world, isn't it? So there's always satellite countries and satellite conflicts between the big powers.
So you think that Venezuela can be understood like as a proxy conflict for a bigger geopolitical counterbalance of powers?
Yeah, you can look at it like that. But I also think there's a lot of problems within the country. So.
And do you think that those problems should be solved internationally in terms of a democratic alliance of countries to help Venezuela out of its crisis? Or do you think that Venezuela could do it on its own?
That's a tough one, isn't it?
Sí, el régimen de Maduro ha sido apoyado por Rusia, sí, evidentemente, por Rusia, China y Cuba.
¿Y cómo es posible que Maduro diga que Venezuela ha sido invadida por poderes externos cuando es tan evidente que ha vendido la soberanía del país a estas fuerzas?
No, yo creo que al revés, ha sido ellos los que se han apoyado de Rusia y Cuba para ir en contra de Estados Unidos y ver su, y oprimir al pueblo venezolano.
¿Tú crees que Venezuela, de cierta manera, como Cuba en los años 60, es una especie de guerra fría?
Puede ser. Puede ser que Rusia utilice a Venezuela para ir en contra de Estados Unidos.
No food, no water, no electricity. Well, nothing really, just putting money on his pockets. Excuse me, good morning. Have you heard about Venezuela?
No.
Yes, you have. Yes, you have. Hello, good morning.
What are you doing here then?
I'm with friends and we work for the channel Santos L, so I do invite you to log into YouTube and to hit and watch our videos. We're just Venezuelans concerned about the situation, and we're also very interested in understanding what people think about our crisis, because from our perspective, of course, we're so embedded in the severe consequences of what has happened that we cannot sometimes take a step back and look at the big picture.
Okay.
And what do you think Venezuelans should do on the face of their own crisis? Do you think that they should appeal to democratic countries around the world? Because the option, the alternative is that, at, as to the point, America has been extremely, what we would see as a form of solidarity with the democratic opposition in Venezuela.
Does democracy really exist? I'm sorry. I don't believe democracy is true. Democracy really exists. I think the USA and its so-called democratic allies are just out for their own personal gain, for their own financial and economic gain.
And where do you have an allegiance? Would you say, or you have a?
I'm a supporter. Well, I am a supporter of democracy, but more important, I'm a supporter of the rule of law, and I believe that Maduro has broken all our democratic institutions. So I think that the future for Venezuela is restoring. Strong and healthy institutions for freedom.
Yeah, and I mean, I've seen when it gets to the point where your leader's making jokes about the Maduro diet and this kind of stuff, it's a very dangerous situation, I think.
Do you think you could spread the word? Because something that is important for us is that you, are you English?
Yeah.
You have the opportunity to speak freely about these things. Do you imagine how powerful that makes you?
So powerful, and I like to tell people about things that happen in the world, so that's really good.
The Venezuelans elected this president to be their president in free elections in 2017. Free elections where there were foreign observers saying the elections were clean.
Political parties were banned.
Political party? Well, I know that the ex-Spanish president Zapatero was there and he said there were clean, free elections. I know the ex-USA president, the very old guy, what's his name, from the 1980s, what's his name? I can't remember the guy's name.
It's become a bit of a farce.
So true that Maduro today said that he's going to enlist 3 million militaries, but not to protect the country from, you know, American intervention, but to grow food and do agriculture.
Yeah, sounds like North Korea, but doesn't it?
Exactly. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
I think we're fed a lot of propaganda.
But you just said that democracy doesn't exist, so why is it relevant to say that Maduro was...
I think he was freely elected by his population. I think the country has been strangled by economic sanctions. This didn't happen 1 or 2 years ago. This has been going on since about 2003, 2006. They started to strangle them with economic sanctions. They started to try and strangle the country. They've started to try and create a revolution and turn the population against the democratically elected government. And this is what they're trying to do. And if it doesn't work this way, they'll probably just move in with force like they did in Iraq and destroy the country for their own personal gain.
What would you say to the Venezuelans? Imagine Venezuelans your age who have just in the future no possibilities of prospect. What would you say to them?
I would say that I will try and help them, and you need to always look up and just try and be happy even though some things can't be.
A question that Venezuelans are wondering, and the rest of the world, is why suddenly two SAM missiles arrive in Venezuela? What are they bringing? Excuse me, good morning. Have you heard about the Venezuelan crisis?
No.
Not at all. I don't know in what world does she live in. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day. Lindo, no? Oh, excuse me. Hello, good morning. Do you know about Venezuela?
Yes, I do.